Okay, good morning students. How are you? Very good, very fine. How are your parents? Are you staying at home and keeping yourself safe? Yes, you should stay at home, keep yourself safe, and at the same time, you should make use of our time to learn something. You should not forget our academics. That is the purpose we started these online classes. I think you have studied Unit 1 and Unit 2. Yes? Very good. Now, we shall begin Unit 3. In our English, we are beginning now Unit 3. What is the name of this Unit 3? Can anyone know? At least those who have textbooks. Yes, you are right. Unit 3 is Humanity. What is the title of Unit 3? Humanity. Humanity meaning kindness, sympathetic. We should be kind to others. We should have sympathy for others. We should show our love to others. Then only we can make them happy. We can also be happy. So this is the main theme of third unit, Humanity. This unit consists of one lesson and one poem. A reading and B reading together, it's only one lesson. The name of the lesson is, see here, The Selfish Jain. The Selfish Jain. And this is a play. This lesson, Selfish Jain, is a play. One act play which can be acted on the stage. You like to watch dramas? Do you like to act in dramas? Very good. So here we have an interesting play. The title of the play is The Selfish Jain, written by Oscar Wilde. What is the name of the author? Oscar Wilde. Okay, it is very interesting to study this play, to read this play. All those who have textbooks, you can open your textbooks and read this lesson. While explaining the lesson, you can follow it in your textbooks. Is it clear? Very good. Now, let me introduce the characters in this lesson. The main characters, there are two. Who are they? The first one is known as Old Jain. First character is known as Old Jain. And he is very selfish Jain. Selfish, you know the meaning of the word selfish. Selfish meaning one who is interested only in oneself. I am interested only in myself. If you are interested only in yourself, in your own happiness, not others' happiness, that is called selfishness. So, the beginning of the play, the old Jain was very selfish character. Not interested in others' happiness. Later he changed his attitude, he changed his behavior. Then he was known as the Jain. The Jain. Here the Jain is kind character. Kind character. Opposite of selfish character, here it is kind character. Both are only one. They are not two different characters, only one person. The first is very selfish, so he is known as Old Jain. Later, he changed his behavior and became good, became kind. So he is known as the Jain. So don't get confused, they are not two, they are only one. So this is the main character. And of course, we have also few children playing or acting in this play. Clear? So, do you think selfishness is a good character? Can anyone tell me? Selfishness. If I am selfish, what do I do? I don't share anything with others. I don't like others to be happy. I want everything for me. Egoistic. I am very selfish, self-centered, egoistic. I want everything for myself. I want to be happy. I don't want others to be happy. Is it a good character? No. Okay? Now, we shall, those who have textbooks, you open them. Open your textbooks, all those who have. Some of you have old books. Okay? You open those books. And I will read and explain the lesson. You follow the lesson in your books. And I have also written some meanings. Okay? So if you don't know the meanings, you can look at the board, know the meaning, and you can easily understand the lesson. Are you ready? Very good. Now, an old Jain addresses the audience directly. Old Jain, the selfish Jain, comes to the stage and he speaks to audience who are listening, who are watching the play. The action plays out behind him as describes it. So, what does the old Jain say? See here. I once owned a large, lovely garden with soft green grass. The old Jain had a very big, large, lovely, beautiful garden filled with so much of green grass, soft green grass, and so many flowers once upon a time, not at present. Here and there over the grass stood beautiful flowers like stars. So describing, comparing, the flowers are compared like stars. Flowers are so beautiful that they look like stars, shining stars. And there were 12 peach trees that in the spring broke out into delicate blossoms. In my garden, there are 12 peach trees. Peach, it's a soft fruit, a small soft fruit, it's peaches. Do you know, have you eaten this peach? Very delicious fruit. So in the selfish Jain's garden, 12 peach trees were there. Then what happened in the spring? What is the spring? Spring is a season. Spring season. See here, spring. Season between winter and summer. Soon after winter, we get spring season. Generally, we don't like winter season, it's very cold, we can't play outside. But after winter comes a beautiful season called spring season. So, during the spring season, what happened to peach trees? They broke out into delicate blossoms. Delicate blossoms meaning tender flowers. Delicate blossoms meaning tender flowers. And there were tender flowers on the trees. A pink and pearl. And in the autumn, bore rich fruit. That in the autumn season, the trees gave delicious fruit, rich fruit. The Jain, selfish Jain, enjoyed his garden. Enjoyed the flowers, enjoyed the fruit in his garden. He was happy. But what happened? The birds sang on the trees and sang so sweetly that the children used to stop their games in order to listen to them. During the spring season, the birds used to come and settle on all the trees and they sing beautiful songs. See here. They sang so sweetly. The birds, various birds, came to his garden and sang sweet songs. And the children were playing their games at that time. They stopped their games only to listen to the songs, sweet songs of these birds. Do you like to listen to birds singing early in the morning? Yes. If you want to listen to birds singing early in the morning, what should you do? What should you do? Yes, you should wake up early. You should wake up early from your bed. Come out. Then only you can hear the birds singing in the morning hours. Okay? Every afternoon, as they were coming from school, the children used to go and play in my garden. Every day, the afternoon, after school hours, the children were going home. Did they go home directly? No. What did they do? They used to enter the Jain's garden, selfish Jain's garden or the old Jain's garden. They used to play games, various games in his garden. In his garden. Children used to play because there was a lovely garden, beautiful garden. Every afternoon as they were coming from school, the children used to play in my garden. M-Y-M-Y is written in capital letters. That shows that the Jain was very selfish character. When it's mine. But one day I came back. That means when children were playing in his garden for so many days or months or even years, the Jain was not there. In his house or in his castle, he went somewhere. In his absence, the children used to play so many games. When the Jain came back, he found these children entering his garden and playing games. Okay, then what did the Jain do? Did he allow them to enter in, come in and play? Or did he stop them playing? See here. I had been to visit my friend, the Cornish Bogle, and had stayed with him for 7 years. For a long period, Jain went to visit one of his friends. His name is Cornish Bogle. He stayed with his friend not for 1 month or 2 months or not for 1 year. He stayed with his friend for a long period of 7 years. He enjoyed being with his friend 7 years time. I had said all that I had to say and I determined to return to my own castle. After spending 7 years with his friend, he said all that he had to say and he decided to go back to his own castle, his own garden. Okay children, then we will continue the lesson in our next class. All the best.